Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. I'm so happy to see you again. And if you're new, hi, hello, my name is Sandra. I would love you to be a part of the Sup fam, so you know what to do. Click subscribe down there and then be a member. So today's video is going to be a first impression on product that is not new at all. This product has been sitting in a basket, or actually two baskets, for about 3 or 4 months now. Oops. And I'm going to show you both of them. This one was from a makeup swap with Julie. I'm going to leave the video down below or up in the card in this side, I think. And then I got this one. And this box contains all the product I have bought in a year or so. And I never got around to try them. So we're going to jump into these two baskets and hopefully get a full face or first impression on older product I have. So if you'd like to see that, then keep on watching. So first up is this one, and I'm going to pop up a close-up of this product, of all the product, because I feel like this is more easier for you to see. And oh, this is dirty. I need to clean it before a close-up. But this is the Rimmel London BB Cream Radiant 9-in-1 Skin Perfecting Super Makeup. And this is in the shade Very Light. And I don't know. I'm really, really fair. I am. But I don't know if this is going to be a little bit too light for me. And this has got a SPF of 20. So we like that. So shall we pop it on? I don't have any primers. I don't think so. I will have a look really, really quick. Nope, I don't have any primer, so I'm just going to pop this on. And this is how it looks like. This is really, really rosy in the undertone. I can tell by the shade of it. I don't like that. I'm just going to pop this on. I don't know if you can tell, but this one is not my shade. This is a more rosy undertone, and I do have a more neutral, little bit slightly to the warmer side. So this is not good. No. But I will make it work. We can make it work. I don't know how I feel about this one. It sits on my skin really, really weird. Nope, I don't like that. I really, really don't like that. I'm going to zoom you in so you can see how it looks on my skin. My skin is not dry right now. I got really, really nice, better and hydrated skin. So I'm just going to zoom you in so you can see it right here, because it looks really, really messy. I don't know if you can tell, but right here, this area. Oh. This is not pretty. Can you see that? This sits on my skin really, really weird. But the finish is really, really nice. It makes my skin look really, really glowy. Like, really, really glowy. I really, really like that. I don't know if I use my finger, if that works a little bit better. It gives him more coverage. Holy smokes. But no, can you see that? No. I'm going to take it all off and then put on another foundation, because this is not pretty at all. And when I'm sitting here and let it dry a little bit, it's really, really heavy on my skin. Maybe I should try it up with a primer instead. Okay, we will try it with a primer, and I can see in a minute or so if I don't like it with a primer. And if it doesn't work with a primer, then I'm going to take on another foundation. So I'm just going to take primer from my drawer. 1 minute. Alright, I'm going to take this primer. This is my Holy Grail primer, and I really, really like it. So I know this is going to work. And if it doesn't work with this one, it doesn't work at all. This is the Max Factor Face Finity All Day Primer, and this is such a beautiful primer. Second shot. We're going to try again. I'm a little bit afraid, because I really, really want to like this, because this is perfect for every day if I don't want to have too much on, but just a little bit. And my skin looks really, really nice with this on. Don't get scared or anything right now, but my skin is burning a little bit. That is not a great feeling. I will give it a second shot. So I'm just going to see how it lays on top of this primer. So I'm just going to pop a little bit on, because I don't want to put it all on just to take it off again if it doesn't work. Okay, I think the primer is the way to do it. I really, really think you have to use a primer with this one, because my skin looks a little bit better. Oh, maybe that was too early to say it. My nose looks a little bit weird. But I'll try to build up in this area and see if it looks okay, or is it just clumps up and looks weird again and patchy. It actually looks a lot better. Yeah, I'm going to zoom in so you can see it. So I don't know if you can tell, but right here it looks a lot better. So I think I will take this on and then I'll be right back. I'm getting a little bit frustrated right now because I'm going to zoom in so you can see it. My nose looks so crazy and it starts to take off over here. I don't know if it's my sponge that is removing the product again, but can you see that? That is so weird. So yeah, I don't like this. I really, really don't like it. I would not recommend this one. This is not good. No. So I'm going to remove it all and then take another foundation. I'm going to see if I have any powder down here. Powder. Nope. So I'm going to take a concealer and a powder from my drawer and then I'll be right back. No, hold on. I found a product I really want to try and I don't want to put this on top of powder, so we're going to put it under powder. That is this one. This is the Revlon Liquid Highlighter in the shade Unicorn Elixcir. I really, really want to try this, and this has been sitting in this box for maybe 3 months now, so I want to try it now. And so pretty. This is so holographic. Don't know if my dropper is working because it doesn't pick any product. Oh no, it's not. What is wrong with you? Can you see this? I'm squeezing this really, really hard. Nope, no product is coming up in this one, so great start. I don't know if I need to shake it up a little bit. Maybe it's got a little bit goopy down there, I don't know. Okay, then we will try again. Nothing. I don't know how to get it out. I know I can put a little bit on the back of my hand and then apply it with my finger. So we will try that and then if I like it, I will see if I can fix this dropper because this is so annoying. Or maybe there's no product in it. There has to be some product in it. It's completely full. So that is not because of that. So I'm just going to take the little bit from the back of my hand and apply it right here. This is not a typical highlighter. I know that. This is a more funny going out highlighter or festival highlighter. Oh my god, I love it. And it doesn't sit on my skin weirdly or anything. It just melt right into my skin and the oil from it doesn't remove my foundation. Yay! So I am really, really happy about this one. This is so pretty. Bronzer, whoops, I got three. I got this Milani Baked Bronzer in the shade number 4 Glow. And then I got this Too Faced Chocolate Soleil in Medium Deep. And then we got this Betty Lou Mani Nicer, yeah. So I'm going to swatch all of them and see which one I like the best. Because I'm not going to pop all of them on. But I really want to find the right tone for my skin. I think I will go for this one in the middle, and that is the Too Faced Soleil Bronzer. Oh my god. And I'm going to take this brush and use this teeny tiny mirror. This is so cute. Alright, it went a little bit crazy over here. Don't judge me, okay? The color exploded a little bit on my face. Alright, I managed to save it a little bit. And then I'm going to use a blush. Yeah, I'm going to use a blush today. And we got this one. I think it's a blush. This is, oh yeah, powder blush. This is from Pitcure Perfect in the shade C1 Bella Mare. Oh. Sandra, why did you do that? No! I just stabbed my finger right in the middle of the powder and made it explode. This is the blush right here. This is such a stunning blush. So I'm just going to pop this on. Oh! I don't know if you can tell, but this is really, really dusty. It's really, really soft, but it's really, really dusty at the same time. That is so pretty. Okay, this is a crazy blush. Oh my god. What? I didn't expect that at all. Okay. I think I managed to save it, but I don't know. Alright, the next step is my brows. And I think I have a brow product right in here. Then I found the brow product. And that is the SM Make Me Brow in the shade Dark, I think. Brownie Brows. So I'm just going to try this on. I've heard this is a dupe for Give Me Brow from Benefit. So I will see if that is true. I have tried the other one and I love it. Love it, love it, love it. So we will see if this one is dark enough, because I got really, really dark hair, so I really want to have them defined but natural at the same time. This is how it looks like with this brow gel in. I really, really like it. I really do. So I think I will reach for this one on my more natural days, because this is a quick and easy way to define my brows without drawing them and try to make them look even and all that. So I really, really like that. Yeah, I like it. So now we are going to put the eyeshadow on, and I got an eyeshadow primer. This is from Mary Kay. This is the eye primer. But the first one I'm trying of the eyeshadow is this one from Milani. This is in the shade Bella Diamond. So I'm just going to take a little bit on this brush. This is the Morphe B70 brush. And I'm just going to pop this on. Ooh, jeez. This is white. All white. This is actually really, really pretty. I really, really like this color. This has a little bit of sheen to it, so I don't mind that. So next up, also from Milani, this one in the shade Bella Caffé. And this is a satin matte. I don't know what the other one was. Highlighter shimmer. Okay, that is why it's shimmery. And then I'm going to use this brush. This is the Morphe MB25, and I'm just going to grab a little bit on this brush and apply it in my crease. This is such a pretty color. I really, really like it. And then I'm going to take the brush with the other eyeshadow on and just try to blend the edges a little bit. Now for the fun part. I got two eyeshadow to put on the actual eyelid, and that is these two right here. This is the E.L.F. Molten Liquid Eyeshadow, and I got it in the shade Busted Copper and Rosegold. I think I will go for the Rosegold because it looks so, so pretty, so I really want to try this. I really like that. It looks a little bit patchy on my eyelid, but I will try to build the color up a little bit so it looks more even. I really, really like this one. This is so pretty. I'm a big, big fan, and now for a part I'm not very, very good at, but I will try this one. This is the Douce Fibrous and Fine Graphic Pen. It looks like this. This is so pointed and so sharp. So I will try to pop this on my lash line. Okay, this is crazy. I can get really, really close to my lash line. You can even use the tip to make it more even and more pigmented and a little bit more tighter. Oh, this is so good. I love this one. This is so good. And this is why I never wear eyeliner, because this is insanely hard for me to apply. Okay, I would just leave it here, or otherwise I'm getting all the way up here and I won't undo. So this is how the liner looks like, and yeah, I know this is not the prettiest look I have done so far, but I am trying, okay? I'm really, really trying. Alright, the last thing we're missing is the lips, and for that I got two products. I got this one. This is the W7 Lip Twister in the shade Nude. And this is brand new, as you can see, it's all sealed. So I'm just going to line my lips with this one. This is the lip liner on its own, and yeah, I know my lips looks a little bit uneven. I got a fuller underlip and a weird upper lip. I don't know. It's just a weird shape. But this is how it looks like, and it's really, really pretty. I really, really like the color, but it feels a little bit drying on my lips. So if you have dry lips, maybe use a chapstick or a lip balm or anything before this, so it doesn't look or feel dry. Oh, I got a hair. Why? I always got a hair. I'm getting crazy. It's our cat. I just know it's our cat. She's up in my brushes at night, I just know that. So, but this is so pretty, and it doesn't emphasize any of my dry patches on my lips at all. And it doesn't feel sticky. Not that much, so I really like that. So, because I don't want to keep it matte, I will try a lip gloss. And I got this one. I have never tried this one before. This is the Ultra Shiny Lip Lipgloss in the shade Sweet Dreams, and this is by Cien. This is from Lidl, and yeah, I really, really like these type of applicators because I really feel like you can get it on, and yeah, it almost got out of the packaging. Hey, so we're just going to pop it on before it's everywhere. Oh shoot, this is a shiny lip gloss. This is not for fun. It's called Shiny Ultra Shiny Lip Gloss. Oh my god. Okay, I'm going to zoom in. I only put it on the bottom lip. Can you see that? That is insane. And this is the matte part. It tastes like a food. Peaches maybe? Oh, it tastes. It's not taste. It smells good. It tastes like that as well. Don't need it. Just don't need it, but I have to try, okay? It smells really, really good. And it got a little bit of sheen to it. A little bit of glittery sheen to it, but I love it. I love it. This is the final look, and I'm going to run over all the products I've used in this video. So first up, I really, really like these Milani eyeshadow. These two are so, so stunning. I love this one in rose gold. I haven't tried the other one in coppery, but I will try that in the future. But this one in rose gold is so beautiful. I really, really like the lip liner. I think it's okay. And I am such a big fan of this one. Such a big fan. So if you can get your hands on this, do it. This is so beautiful. And I feel moisturizing. And it just looks really, really shiny and delicious. So I would definitely go for this one. This is one of my favorite in this video. And I really, really like, oh, where are you? This one. Make Me Brown from Essence. I really, really like this as well. I don't know how I feel about this Too Faced Cirque du Soleil bronzer, because this is a medium deep, and I'm a more fair to medium skin tone, so I don't know. This one, I'm a little bit so-and-so about this one. This is really, really pretty, and the color is stunning. I don't like that my dropper is broken. I cannot get anything out. And I don't know how I feel about this one, because this is an extra step in my makeup routine. And then we got this Mary Kay eyeshadow primer. I don't know, and yeah, I only worn this for half an hour, so I don't know if it's good or not, but I'm going to leave a little note in the description box below how everything wore, everything new wore in the whole day, so you can see if it worked or not. And then we got this blush, this Circa blush in the shade 01 Bella Mare. Oh, it's called Circa. And it's not, oh, what did I call it? Oh, Pitcure Perfect. It was not Pitcure Perfect. The brand was not Pitcure Perfect, but Circa. Yeah, way to go, Sandra. But this one is really, really pretty. So I think, oh no, we got this one. This Douce Fresh and Fine Graphic Pen. I really, 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 really like this. And I think this is a good eyeliner. I really like how pointed and sharp it is, because this makes it so easy to get all the way to the lower lash line and the bottom lash line, and really make a precise and fine line. But we will see how it holds up. I got a hooded eye, so sometimes my liner transfers to my skin up here. So we will see if that happens, and I'm going to leave a note on this one as well. And I think that was it. Oh no, it's not. I totally forgot this one, because I want to forget it, okay? This Rimmel BB Cream, no. Don't buy this one. Maybe if you're oily, maybe you can make it work, but if you have dry or combinated dry skin like me, don't buy it. But otherwise, I would recommend most of this stuff. And especially, I cannot give over this one. And these two. This is my favorite product in this video, yeah. I love them, so I would definitely go for this one if you have to pick one or two products. That is the product I would go for. So yeah, that was it. That was it for this first impression on new product that is not new on the market, but new to me. And I really, really hope you enjoy it. And if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And don't forget, I love you. And then I will see you in my next video. Bye.